I'm Karen Savage. I'm going to talk to you about quality assurance, quality control, and management of CRFs and source documents. So the objectives for this course are to define source documents, list the basic elements of source documents, describe the steps necessary to case report form completion, describe use and management of electronic case report forms, and define the importance of a quality management program. So basically, this comes right out of the guidelines, ICH definition of good clinical practice for source data. It's basically all information in original records and certified copies of original records of clinical findings, observations, or other activities in a clinical trial necessary for the reconstruction and evaluation of the trial. And source data are contained in source documents, and those are the original records or certified copies. So why do we have source documents? So basically, this tells the story of a participant's time on a trial. It's necessary for the reconstruction, evaluation, and validation of clinical findings, observations, and other activities during the clinical trial. It's got to be verifiable, and all the documents need an audit trail. So basically, the source documents and the case report forms have to be attributable, legible, contemporaneous, original, and they've got to be accurate. So we're going to define some source documents and basically talk about what type of things are contained as source documents. Some examples are, depending on the type of trial or study you have, could be hospital records, a research chart that's specific to the research procedures you're doing, case report forms used as source documents, and we'll talk about case report forms in a minute. Also, a primary care provider's office chart, so things that happen between research visits. And several times you'll also have laboratory data, radiology,